One person was killed tonight. At least five others were injured. This when a snowplow driver apparently went berserk, and he started smashing cars with a snowplow on the south side. That wild binge began at 82nd and Carpenter and ended with a fatal accident at 95th and Dan Ryan. The arrested snowplow driver, we understand, is a private citizen. He apparently had been hired by the city to help in its snow removal operation. Now, neither the driver nor the dead man have been identified tonight. A deaf sergeant at the Gresham Police Station said that at least 30 people have come down to the police station tonight to report that their cars were hit by the wild snowplow. We hope to have videotape on those smashed cars coming up a little later in tonight's newscast. Jim?
And as Jim Tillman told us earlier, looks like another bad rush hour for Chicago commuters tomorrow. Rich Samuels is at CTA Control Center, and Rich is looking at the disaster plan for the morning. Rich, what is it?
Well, Jim, I almost hesitate to use the word plan because of the connotations that word has come to have over the last couple of days. But the basic thing the CTA is trying to do is simply keep the trains running, something that's very contingent upon what happens tonight. And the big problem is, of course, blowing ice and snow. The CTA tonight's running as many extra trains as it can over its rapid transit lines and asking motormen to work overtime if at all possible. The reason is simple. Heavy train traffic should break through the drifting snow and keep third rail ice from forming. This evening's rush hour was better than this morning's, but there was still extreme crowding on late running buses held up by traffic. Crowding on the rapid transit lines too, where a third of the rolling stock remained out of service. CTA traffic controllers devised remedies for each setback, but the logic of those remedies sometimes eluded commuters, who now and then saw empty trains zooming through their stations as they waited. On the whole, though, the CTA felt tonight's rush hour showed considerable improvement over those of last week.
Please avoid pushing and shoving. However, step all the way into the cars when the train does stop at your station, then stand clear of the doors so the train may proceed.
There was near chaos at Northwestern Station. Thousands of commuters let off from work early by benevolent employers arrived at the terminal before their rush hour train. Northwestern officials threw out the timetable, sent off whatever trains were available as soon as they were filled, and canceled all the express service. For Illinois Central Gulf commuters, the rush hour was prolonged until after 8 this evening. Falling ice from the overhead power lines caused the delays for several thousand. Some said they'd waited up to 3 hours for a train.
Well, the ICG says that a train finally was supposed to leave that station at 8:30 this evening. We've been unable to verify that. On the CTA at this hour, the Skokie Swift line remains out of service, and the CTA says they're not even going to try to go out and liberate that line until daybreak tomorrow morning. There's still an across-the-platform transfer at Davis Street and Edmondson on the Howard Linden line. So things change very radically from minute to minute, and we'll be back later in this expanded broadcast with a commuter update for tomorrow. Chuck and Jim?
Okay, thank you, Rich.
Okay, Rich. It's a good place to meet people down at the train station tonight, shoulder to shoulder there. Arlington Park racetrack officials tonight are trying to determine just how much the snow has cost them in cold, yes, cold cash. They say it's still too early to estimate the cost of repairing three large sections of roof that collapsed today under the weight of all that snow. Nobody was injured in the accident. Sections of the roof over the grandstand caved in around noon today. Workers were trying to prevent another section from collapsing tonight. A track spokesman said that the collapse would probably not affect the Friday opening of a recreational vehicle show, which they say could be moved into other buildings inside the racetrack complex. And not too far from the racetrack, a portion of the roof of the Carson Perry Scott store in the Ranhurst Shopping Center gave way. The store was closed for inventory, and nobody was injured. The store plans, though, to reopen tomorrow. Jim?
By the way, in case you just tuned in, this is an expanded NewsCenter 5 newscast here, and we'll be on until 10:30 tonight. After that last storm that hit us, NewsCenter 5 revealed that many Chicago hospitals did not have emergency access routes adequately plowed. Today, there are indications that the city has been attempting to live up to its claim that hospitals are a top priority in snow removal. However, at the city's largest hospital, still problems. Health reporter Barry Kaufman has that story.
Cook County Hospital removes its own snow, not only from hospital grounds, but also from city streets that provide access for emergency vehicles and to other hospital facilities. Hospital officials told NewsCenter 5 they plow and hire a private firm to plow because the city doesn't. If the hospital didn't pay to have the job done, officials said emergency routes would remain snow-clogged. Earlier today, city officials said they were looking into the problem and reiterated that hospital access routes were a top priority. But it wasn't until shortly before 6 tonight that city crews arrived. One crew member said they were here to help clear emergency access routes. Before noon, city snow crews had cleared streets around Michael Reese, the city's second busiest hospital. Michael Reese raised the issue of hospital snow priority last week when officials there said city snow removers had virtually ignored them and didn't consider hospitals a priority. A subsequent NewsCenter 5 survey revealed 10 other hospitals had similar complaints. Today, several small hospitals said surrounding streets were again clogged by cars or snow, but none of the larger hospitals surveyed today reported any serious difficulty. The latest storm prompted the Chicago Fire Department to mobilize extra emergency medical vehicles. The regular fleet of 40 vehicles is being bolstered by an additional 32. And some suburban ambulances called supervisory personnel into service, this to get more ambulances on the street. We haven't run short of blood yet, but regional blood officials are concerned. The weather today kept away donors, raising the possibility that blood may have to be flown in from other cities. As far as cleaning streets, the city's response, at least for some hospitals, seemed better today. But the failure to quickly help clear access here at the city's busiest hospital again raises questions about just how hospitals fit into the city's snow removal plan. At Cook County Hospital, this is Barry Kaufman, NewsCenter 5.
Well, access is nearly impossible on a lot of state and county highways in northern Illinois and northwest Indiana tonight. Crews are working to keep the highways passable, but the drifting snow is making that a difficult task. Now, here's a list of the major roads that are closed tonight. Interstate 80 closed west of I-55 in the Joliet area. I-57 southbound closed near Kankakee, and in the same area, I-55 is closed near Route 83. Other interstates are open, but they're restricted to one lane in some places. Apparently, the hardest hit area is Kane County, which reports all highways are closed. In DuPage County, most roads are nearly closed. Snow crews are still fighting a losing battle. And in the Joliet area, state routes 53, 34, 13, 126, 52, and 30 are all closed. County roads in that area are also in bad shape. In northwest Indiana, where snow is still falling, 421 is closed north of Route 30, and 2 is closed near Valparaiso. The Indiana Tollway and interstates in that area are ice and snow-packed, but they are open. In short, it's bad out there, and you should not even attempt to drive it if you can possibly avoid it. Now, one of the great thrills in life is going up in a helicopter in a snowstorm. Not many people do that. But late this afternoon, Chuck Henry decided to check out the snow situation from the air in all of that beautiful gusty wind.
By now, you've had a chance to see the effects of this blizzard from the ground. What we're going to do now is get in this helicopter, fly over the city and the suburbs, and see the effects of this blizzard from the air.
I know what you're thinking. Anybody who goes up flying in this weather has got to be a thrill seeker. Well, at times, this did prove to be a very rough ride. Most noticeable from the air were the numerous roof collapses. These were large commercial buildings like the Shure plant. They make microphones out in Arlington Heights. The roof gave way here despite week-long efforts to remove the snow. Commuter trains were a lot slower today, if you could get one at all. On the highways, the problem seemed to be stalled cars, especially on the on and off ramps to the expressways. At O'Hare International, the world's busiest airport, things were down to a crawl. Only one of the seven runways was operational for both takeoff and landings, so that meant lengthy delays today and again tonight. Despite 9 inches of new snow, Chicagoans, as you could tell from the air, were still able to get around the city. But let me assure you, the best way to do that is on the ground, not bouncing around in a helicopter, at least not today.
I have to tell you, I love to fly, and I don't normally get airsick. But today was one of those days.
One of those days.
I have to tell you that when we landed, the crew, one of them hit the deck and just kissed the ground. I mean that literally.
Well, those things, you know, everybody thinks if you're in a helicopter, if you have to come down, you can. But in snow, you can't do that because of that rear rotor. When the snow is this deep, it'll hit that snow.
I don't know if it's any consolation, but the helicopter pilot told me, he said, look, today you're safer in a helicopter than you would be in a fixed-wing aircraft. He said, the wind doesn't bother us as much. Ho, ho, ho. I tell you, it was like being inside a washing machine. As you just saw, the airport, O'Hare International, was virtually shut down early today with just a limited number of flights coming in and out of the airport. A spokesperson at the airport told us that people are stranded there tonight, but we had one person call in to describe the situation at the terminal as a real circus. And as Roberta Baskin reports, there are many unhappy people. They're unhappy with the way the airlines are notifying them of the cancellations.
It's not a big surprise that the world's busiest airport is virtually at a standstill again. But what is surprising is the number of people who called up the airlines to check on their flight and were advised that it was either on time or a short delay. So people bundled into cars, buses, and taxis and headed out in the blizzard. Apparently, it takes a trip to the airport to get the truth.
He told me to come on out. My flight would leave as scheduled. So when I got here, the flight not leaving. They don't know what gate, when, what time, or nothing. And I'm sick. I could stay there now.
Well, we don't cancel until the last possible moment based on the conditions that are happening at the time. And we will call people 3, 4, or 5 hours in advance, and then during that interim, their flight will cancel.
Too many would-be travelers who were encouraged by the airlines to make the trip out here are finding that O'Hare is the end of their destination. At O'Hare, Roberta Baskin for NewsCenter 5.
Well, these people stranded at the airport or at work or downtown have had a lot to put up with this winter. Stephen Ray's downtown tonight, and he reports on how some people are making do.
This is the Hyatt Regency, one of many hotels in downtown Chicago, hit hard by last-minute reservations. People stuck in downtown Chicago. It's spotty. Some hotels are full. Others have plenty of room. But it's clear that a lot of people either couldn't or didn't want to go home and then wake up and face the commuter mess tomorrow morning. Of course, being stuck in downtown Chicago isn't all bad. We can report that at least some people traded their commuter woes for a glass or two of bubbly. And while bars were not mobbed, there was at least a fitting party atmosphere. Many hotels, like the Holiday Inn Apparel Mart, received scores of last-minute reservations. It is almost sold out. The Radisson almost filled up. However, the Marriott right next door had plenty of room. One hotel was especially packed. The Midland Hotel. It is one of three hotels left in Chicago's financial district. All 300 rooms were sold out, taken by the blue chippers who must be early to bed, early to rise, and right on time when the markets open tomorrow. The Midland even set up two dorms with extra beds at no charge for the regular customers. Yep, a lot of people are stuck in downtown Chicago tonight, away from home and family, but making the best of it.
I got a 9:05 train this morning that got in at 10 minutes to 1 this afternoon, so I decided I'd better stay here for the durations.
I wouldn't want to lose a lot of money in the market tomorrow by being late by taking trains.
Do you mind being stuck downtown?
No, it's kind of really fun. It has a warm atmosphere and the hotel is friendly, and they're just small enough to cater to everybody's needs.
And so it goes. Companies that have to make sure that someone is around to do the work tomorrow are footing the bill tonight at hotels. I trust NewsCenter 5 has made similar arrangements. Back to you.
Okay, I hope he makes it home.
Check on that.
Hope he makes it home tonight. Well, we'll have more of tonight's special report on the snowstorm and all of the headaches that's come along with it. We'll have that after this.